This video shows how to import a PDF map. In this example, the format is A4 and the scale is 1000. We'll convert this PDF to DXF with Inkscape. Create first a new A4 document and set the units properly. Then import the PDF file and recenter it. Save in AutoCAD DXF R14. In the worst case, you don't have a native PDF file, but only a paper print, like this one, that you can scan and import as a picture. Now, if you zoom, you only get pixels, because the scale is only valid if you respect the format of the print. You need to readjust the size of this picture to fit the A4 frame. Now, to get the contours from this picture, you can use trace bitmap command that will draw contour from edge detection. After a little time, you get this result. Then you can delete the picture. And save in DXF format. But in this case, the size of the file is much bigger than the one you get from the original PDF file. Now, to import this map, you can create a terrain part, for example, in large range, so you will be able to design geometrical elements above a kilometer range. Make sure you are in building space planning. And import the DXF file. Setting meters instead of millimeters is a way to rescale your model of 1000 factor. But you can also manually rescale afterwards. You can check that the scale is correct by measuring elements, like in this case, these two lines that should be 100 meters away from each other. Let's geolocate this map using the coordinate reference system that can be read on it. Here it's the CC49 that is legal to be used in the Paris area. This website will help you retrieve the corresponding EPSG code 39049. If you open the installation file of CATIA, this one, you can extract the projection system resource file and save it in a window folder, in a Windows folder. And then import it as a reference because it's a shared resource. Now we'll create a site. In large range again. And we'll set geolocation based on the newly imported CRS. Roughly locate around Paris. And drag and drop the map below it. We'll also use the CC49 CRS for the map. But the easiest way is to delete geolocation and to recreate it from the site geolocation just above. This point on the map will give us an accurate location with x and y coordinate. So let's rebuild this point on the map. Put the robot on it. And use this location to shift the origin of the map. Now the x and y coordinate can be entered from the map values. If this map is to be used to evaluate feasibility of a construction project, it's always wise to double check that geolocation and scale are okay. An easy way to do this is to import an OpenStreetMap file in a new terrain part. You can extract data from this website. And import. As you can see here, the match is really good, so this context is safe to perform measurements.